My head was there when you found me. Me and you went to hell, looked back just to find me. And I thought I had everything, I was lonely. Now you're my everything, I was lonely.
Go to NFLShop.com and gear up.
The NFL Today on CBS Sports is presented by Ram Trucks, built to serve.
And welcome back to the NFL Today. And now Amazon takes you out to the sights and sounds of the game between the Raiders and the Jets. So let's take you out to East Rutherford with our announcers, Spiro Dias and Adam Archuleta.
James, a gorgeous autumn afternoon here in the New York City area. It is starting to get a little chilly, temperatures in the upper 30s, but plenty of sunshine, blue skies, as we are set for a battle in the AFC between the 6-5 Las Vegas Raiders and the winless New York Jets, still chasing that first elusive win of 2020. Here's what the playoff picture looks like in the AFC. The Raiders, you see where they sit in that number 8 slot. Right now on the outside looking in, as they are even record-wise with the Ravens at 6-5. Hi, everyone. Welcome to East Rutherford alongside Adam Archuleta. I'm Spiro Dias. Boy, the Raiders last week, one of the more stunning results of Week 12, blown out Adam in Atlanta. You can feel the urgency for this team now as they try to bounce back.
Yeah. Look, the Jets are winless, but this is a big one for the Raiders. And for a football team that has designs on getting to the playoffs, they can't let last week's loss linger into this game.
Yeah, there were so many surprising parts of that Raiders defeat, blowout defeat in Atlanta, but specifically the offense. They had scored 30-plus in their previous three games. The offense was rolling. Different story last week, and Derek Carr suffered through one of the worst games of his career.
It was an ugly game. It was uncharacteristic, and really it was just kind of flat-out weird. The tone setter was this play on their first drive. 4th-and-1, Josh Jacobs stuffed. They were undisciplined. A season high 11 penalties gave the Falcons 5 first downs. An unacceptable 5 giveaways, 3 strip sacks from Derek Carr, and then this pick 6 to Deion Jones. Now, last week, in my opinion, was more the exception rather than the rule. Derek Carr has played some really good football this season, his best season. He's at his best, Spiro, when he's spreading the wealth. But what I like about his game is how he has made those big-time throws down the field.
Carr in the offense will be without one of their biggest pieces. No Josh Jacobs today, hurt his ankle in the fourth quarter last week. And so that means that the former Denver Bronco, Devontae Booker, makes his first start as a Raider. Meantime, bad year for the Jets. Worst start in franchise history. They lose today. They'll match the longest losing streak in the 60-year history of their franchise. Adam Gase shouldering a lot of the blame this week, saying that, you know, it's on his shoulders, the lack of development that we've seen from Sam Darnold.
Yeah, not a lot of good vibes or positivity around Gase, Darnold, or the Jets. But if you are looking for something to look forward to, there is some positivity and some potential in this passing game. Darnold has made some great throws. How about this nice little feather to Breshad Perriman down the field between the safety and the corner? In his progression game, his favorite weapon, Jamison Crowder. He's reliable. He's his security blanket, and he's somebody who has had a great chemistry with Sam Darnold. Last week was Darnold's first game back nursing the shoulder. He also had his three top receivers healthy for one of the first times this season. He had some wild throws, some great throws, but he also had the head scratchers. He's got to eliminate the catastrophic turnover for the Jets to have a chance.
And now do Project Smarter, presented by the Home Depot.
Not a lot of headliners up front for the Vegas Raiders, but Max Crosby, a great mix of energy, passion, and he leads the Raiders with 6 sacks on the season. Quinn Williams is starting to show why he was the 3rd pick. He's dominant, he's a force, and starting to learn how to rush the passer. The Raiders have to be smart. No penalties, no giveaways. Raiders football, clean and efficient to get back on track. And for the Jets up front, pressure Carr early. Make it tough. Do not allow him to settle into a passing game with great timing.
Well, John Gruden, silver and black, currently on the outside looking in trying to get into that top seven in the expanded NFL postseason field that begins this season. Jets and Raiders next. Inside MetLife Stadium on a brisk 37-degree Sunday afternoon here in Week 13. As we are just about set for the 6-5 Las Vegas Raiders, the 0-11 Jets will have the kickoff next. You're watching the NFL on CBS.